scholar who has been ceaselessly associated with this endeavor of ours since 2015. In fact, the first book that we launched in this series was in the IIC in September 2015, and it was launched by Professor Dev Roy. And he has been with us continuously through his writings, through his active engagement with us. To my senior co-editor for this volume, former DGITBP, former formidable police commissioner of Kolkata, Sri Ranjit Pachnanda, a very warm welcome and gratitude for pushing through this volume. He kept at it, Ranjitji kept at it throughout the COVID period, and he was determined that we must come out with this volume at the right time. And of course, I warmly welcome my friend, strategic thinker, a leading expert on water and rivers, fellow Manohar Parikar IDSA, Dr. Uttam Sinha. Without his wholehearted support, continuous application, this volume would not have seen the light of day. And welcome to Sri Rajan Arya, Pentagon Press, and a big thanks to you and to your team. And of course, last but not the least, all of you who have gathered here today after a long hiatus, and thank you for making it possible for us to meet here today. There was no construction of roads or airfields on the border areas, close quotes. This was a continuation of a mindset which had developed in the early decades of independent India. And I'll just take a few more minutes. On 7th November 1959, long before 1962, Dr. Ram Subhag Singh, member of parliament from Jawaharlal Nehru's own party, member of parliament from Bihar, Sasaram, suggested that there should be focused industrialization of India's borders, especially the Nepha region. Nehru poured scorn on him in Lok Sabha. Nehru said, "It is a noble ambition of Dr. Ram Subhag Singh, but before we do that, we have to think of our little country of India. We have to deal with and industrialize it. We might concentrate on industrializing India first before we go across the Himalayas for that purpose." It shows the enthusiasm of our honorable colleagues here in this parliament, but it also shows that in their enthusiasm, they sometimes overshoot the mark, and that is not helpful. This was the response of the then Prime Minister of India to a suggestion made that India's border infrastructure must be strengthened. That Nepha is divorced and disjointed from India. Little country, first let us industrialize India and then Nepha. And second, these suggestions are not helpful. This is what essentially Nehru meant. That approach and policy has been conclusively decimated since 2014, with a dynamic emphasis and drive on defense indigenization, strengthening our border infrastructure, Simanta Vikas, and the pursuit of Atmanirbharta in Suraksha. Strategic and multiple outreaches worldwide in order to enhance the capability of Indian forces, the enhancement of quantity and quality of basic needs and requirements of our jawans, and much more. Dr. Shyama Prasad Mukherjee had argued in the first ever debate in the interim parliament on the international situation and India's defense, he had then said, "A nation must be physically strong and adequately armed before it can proclaim and defend moral doctrines. That nation is truly great which has force and strength at its disposal, but never abuses them for the advancement of self-interest or self-aggrandizement." The national security approach of PM Modi's New India, friends, is in line with that articulation. India aspires to emerge as a leading power standing on solid foundations of a new security vision. This volume examines these aspects and comes out with a credible and detailed narrative of a new paradigm of India's national security.
Information security. And if you, as Dr. Sinha had just mentioned, went through the pages of the book, we realize how deftly and patriotically and in a determined manner the Modi government has faced and dealt with challenges to national security in the interest of the nation and the determined Indians. The creation of the two union territories of J&K and Ladakh were the most momentous achievement of the government since independence. In fact, it has ushered a new phase of development, and these two union territories will see a spate of unhindered development. Earlier, this area was riddled with terrorism, as and the Honorable Home Minister made a statement. There were over 41,500 killings between 89 and 2019. Invisible armies fighting uncivilized proxy wars threatened the basic structure and fabric of democracy. The repudiation of Article 370 and 35A has ushered a new dawn of equity, governance, and development. And with government insisting so much of development, they have empowered grassroots institutions, ushered in a new phase of structure, infrastructure growth, development, employment, and social inclusion. And this has only been due to the determination of the government. And the people in the valley say that the Prime Minister has not only changed.
1.0, 2.0, 3.0 doesn't really matter, because it is the same government with the same continuity in policies. And therefore, we took stock of what we had covered in the initial books. And I know Anirban suggested this is the last. I don't think it is. By the time Shyama Prasad Mukherjee and Anirban are done, there will be 30 volumes, Modi 1.0, 2.0, 3.0, going on up to Modi
30.0.
So we took stock of what we had covered and what we had not covered. And we discovered that we had not really talked about security. The word security means all kinds of different things to different people. There is a broad notion of security, there is a narrow notion of security. In a broad notion of security, in a broad definition of security, economic security is also part of security. But we wanted to have a book on security, because the reason we started with all of these books is, look, the government is doing a lot of things, but these are not normally disseminated. People don't read about them, and people therefore criticize the government, saying the government is not doing anything, which is not quite true. And I mean analytical descriptive pieces, not mere dashboards. So we actually conceived the book before the COVID pandemic. We conceived it because, as I said, whether it was 1.0 or 2.0 didn't really matter. We conceived the book, I think, sometime in the middle of 2019. But we wanted to make it clear that this was security narrowly defined. And we thought one of the best ways of doing that, before we even identified the authors, identified the subjects, was to identify the publisher. We decided to draw up a list, as all editors do, draw up a list of all possible sensible authors who might write, and then we asked them for the subjects on which they would write. And because it was security, all the obvious areas were covered. Yes, the foreign policy part, many dimensions to it. Yes, the border infrastructure part of it, many dimensions to it. Yes, this little bit, an important bit about defining what is India. India has to be one, which means the Northeast is part of India, which means Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh are part of India. So all of that was covered. The LWE part was covered. When every conceivable area was covered, at a meeting of the editors, I asked, for the average citizen, the government's primary responsibility is security, which means external security, which we have covered in terms of the topics, and internal security. And internal security is much more than just the LWE part of it. We use the expression law and order. For decades, the two words law and order have been used in conjunction.
Book of not being cautious while criticizing Shyamaprasad Mukherjee Foundation book, then I also become cautious. There is nothing to criticize here, but henceforth, before criticizing, I will be cautious wherever I am there. So, with that sense, today it is indeed a very special occasion for every one of us who are there in this auditorium. There is a book being released in this same compound about a disaster that was UPA. And a book has also being released in the same compound about a disaster management agency that is called NDA government. It is very difficult not to sound something pompous or something admiring or whatever it is. But when something has been achieved, you should not be short of words also. Because we live in a country where for 70, 72 long years, there was no need to achieve anything to become a celebrity here. It is only on whose left you are, on whose right you are, decided whether you are a celebrity or you are a non-celebrity. It didn't take much here to be labeled as an achiever also in this country. And in this whole lot of achievers and influencers, the real achievers and the real influencers, many a time they didn't find space at all because usually they don't boast about themselves at all. So the last 70 years, whatever it has taken this country to, slowly the true potential of this country is being unmasked in last 7 years. And it is the contribution of very many people because they have all found their rhythm now, they have all found their space now, and they have all found the sunshine where they can blossom. So that has been the biggest achievement of these 7 years of Modi's legacy, the 7 years of Modi's administration. Today, when we have assembled here to just release a book based on the achievements of this government or the vision of this government, I would like to thank every single person who are there in this stage platform, who have made this work possible. We have Dr. Vivek Debroy amongst us, who can easily be called as Akshar Saraswati ke Chaturmukhi Upasak, aise aram se keh sakte hai humne. So, humare paas bahut log hai, including me, hum cut and paste ke experts hai. So, kal Uday Mahavarkar ji ke bhashan sunna, आज कनक सभापति जी के देर इन द ऑडियंस, आज कनक सभापति जी के कुछ लेख पढ़ना, वी सतीश जी के कुछ उपन्यास सुनना, उसके बाद विवेक देवराय जी के भाषण सुनना और कल एक नया भाषण हमारा क्रिएट करना, अगर ये चारों में कोई गए है तो देन दे विल कैच होल्ड ऑफ अस, वी विल आल्सो बी कॉशियस दैट इफ ऑल फोर ऑफ देम पीपल हु हैव लिसन टू ऑल ऑफ फोर ऑफ देम देन वी विल टॉक लेस. सो फॉर द लास्ट 70-75 ईयर this has been the case in many of the aspects. But today people like Dr. Vivek Debroy, what to call him, an economist? And then you get him intermittering on your social media, which doesn't have any connect with social economics. Then you go to an airport, then you catch hold of a book, which is not at all related to anything that he does every day for bread and butter and for country's welfare and development. It is something on Upanishad, something on Mahabharata, something on Ramayana. I feel really proud to say that he is really the Upasak, Chaturmukhi Upasak of Akshara Saraswati we have amongst us today as the principal contributor to this book. That makes the value of this book more than anything, brings up the value of this more than anything else. We have Dr. Ranjit ji, whose passion about security of this country, in its entirety, we were audience to his words. More than 6th of Assam Independence Day was celebrated with pomp and all those in a celebratory mood which was there in the society. Then we had a question, what is so special? I grew up in Karnataka where every Independence Day is a celebration in every part of the state, and after Kargil it is a household celebration.
Before Kargil, it was an administrative exercise or school exercise. But after Kargil, it has become a household exercise now. Even small children, they hoist the flag on top of their house. I was thinking, what was so special? But the Chief Minister told that for the first time in last 69 years, for the first time, Independence Day is being celebrated in all districts. In some district there has to be boycott call, and in some district there has to be a bund call. Then the police, administration, army, everything put together, they have to celebrate the Independence Day celebration. They have to hoist the national flag inside some compound. A national flag inside that compound cannot ever be called as a national flag. It can be by rules a national flag. Unless the people hoist it, people hold it in their hand, then it cannot be called with the sense of purpose that it is a national flag. Now it is happening. Now it is happening across the country. When you see that a Facebook post, whenever a terrorist or a hideout puts the group photo on a social media page, and within 3 months, the commander or the operational in charge there in the valley or in some left-wing troubled area, they tell that the last person in that Facebook page has also been neutralized today, then you feel that you are assured. It doesn't take 15 long years, 20 long years, or for him to come and present himself before the police when he is old or something else. No, it takes only 90 days now. At the most, it takes 90 days to neutralize every single one of them. You feel assured then. You feel assured then. When your leader stands on the stage of the global platform, and when he argues for the country, and when he argues for the developing countries, when he argues for the small countries which doesn't have any leaders or which doesn't have any lobby, and when he is able to take up the word of faith down to face out as far as coal is concerned in COP26, you feel assured. You feel assured. Because till then, till that date, to be very fair, Dr. Vivek Debra, I didn't know the exact meaning of this face down and face out. And what is so special? Everybody started flagging that word from phasing out. So India has achieved phasing down. What is that phasing out and phasing down? After I understood it, and after I understood the international politics behind that word, and after I understood India's concern because of that word, then I started admiring our leader a little more, and admiring our system also a little more. Not only the leader, I took the name with the concerned ministry, I took the name of every single consultant and every single scientist who are there in that discussion, and I am happy to state in front of you today that more than 50% I have talked to them individually. Our country is full of such resources. The only thing is that they needed a platform. They needed a platform. This country was never dearth of individual heroes or individuals with impeccable character. It was never short of people, individuals with impeccable characters. When you talk about Madanlal Dhingra from those days, every single of them, when you saw the gallantry awards being presented by the His Excellency, the President of India, every single person in this country had a bit of tears, some drops of tears in his eyes when he was looking at the TV. What was that? A person risking his life to bring down the dead body of his buddy. Just imagine it. We also live in a society where we start shooting the accident site without being a bit of humanity in us. We keep on shooting the accident site rather than helping the person. In the same way, we have individuals who risk their life just to bring down the dead body of their buddy in our field. Then the second day, I got hold of the book Indian Army Wives. You have to read it. Okay, army men, it is wonderful. But those simple women who may be 10th pass, 12th pass from village background, the way they have behaved, conducted themselves. अच्छा है हम पैम्पलेट थोड़ा अंदर डाल के डाल करके विल मूव ऑन कोई बाहर आ गया तो कुछ तो पूछेंगे इफ दैट डजंट कम आउट विल जस्ट थ्रो द पैम्पलेट इनसाइड एंड मूव अवे क्योंकि परिस्थिति ऐसे रहता है सिचुएशंस विल बी लाइक दैट बट हियर वाज अ मैन हियर वाज अ लीडर हु मेड अस प्राउड व्हेन वी वेंट फॉर कैंपेनिंग फॉर द सेकंड टाइम इन 2019 सो द सेकंड वन ही टोल्ड व्हिच when he addressed every single person in the country also. And that is very important for every one of you who are sitting here. He told in the National College Grounds program that wherever the Indians are there across the globe, or Indians move from the country to various other countries in the globe, we will create a situation where every single person will be proud to say that I am an Indian. will create a situation where he will be proud to say that I am an Indian wherever I am standing across the globe. And today, when I talk to many people across the globe, it is simply we have achieved it. Simply we have achieved it. When the leaders, they thronged to talk to our leader, it was not at all there. Nobody used to talk to us. People know the Sherpas who had gone to Davos. They know. To get the audience, we had to wait for 2-3 days. Neither we are a market, nor we were a leader, nor we were leader. Nothing. To be very rude, we were a begging country. About everything. Today, we are not only begging country. We may seek some help from somebody else, but we are not a banking country now. If some earthquake happens in some remote island, then our...